from coast to coast in Canada.
This should be a dandy.
He scores!
What a beautiful move!
He's hot tonight, folks.
And the Bruins are infuriated. He's waving the white flag.
Oh,
robbed him! I tell you,
robbed him!
Put that save on your VCR machine.
This is a brawl to end all brawls.
They tied the game!
Can you believe it? That's the greatest overtime I've ever seen.
Seen hockey like this.
In his Pittsburgh regular season debut, the first overall pick in the NHL draft, at center, wearing number 87, Sidney Crosby.
Of the Pittsburgh Penguins. Welcome back once again, number 66, Mario Lemieux.
Ladies and gentlemen, for tonight's national anthem, please rise, remove your hats, direct your attention to the flags above the scoreboard. Join us in welcoming international recording superstar and Wexford's own, Miss Christina Aguilera.
Can you see? So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled the land of the free and the home of the
Christina Aguilera with the singing of the national anthem here from the Mellon Arena. This is game number one of 41 on the home slate for the Pittsburgh Penguins. And the Boston Bruins are the opponent tonight in the goaltending matchup. Let's look at our Chrysler goaltenders for tonight. And Bobby, Sebastian Caron gets the call with the unexpected injury in the morning skate today to Jocelyn Thibault.
Oh, was he stellar last night against the Carolina Hurricane, allowing the Penguins to pull a point out of Carolina and come back home. Looking at a rookie in the other end with that big B on his chest. First start, Anna Toivonen. He had tremendous numbers in the minors last year to go along with the numbers you're looking at right there. 932 save percentage last year, and he's in the top 10 in every category, Mike. We already saw one of those last night at Mr. Ward.
Yes, we did.
That's who we got tonight.
Well, Dean Warren and Eric Furlatt are going to be the two referees. Mark Stuchek and Derek Amell will work the lines, and immediately a faceoff And from center ice, they stop the play just 6 seconds in. The Penguins against the Bruins, and the Bruins have owned the number against the Pens over the last few years. It was a long streak where the Penguins could not lose to the Bruins. Now it's reversed. Here's Sergei Samsonov ahead to Joey Thornton, who takes center ice, and an offside call against the Boston Bruins. And there is Eddie Olczyk, the head coach of the Pittsburgh Penguins. He was a little surprised at what happened this morning, too, and with Jocelyn Thibault. But Andy Kyoto has been recalled from Wheeling to the Eastern League, and he'll be in uniform tonight as a backup for Sebastian. And here is the play. Along the right side of the Penguins in. Joe Thornton. Boston's lost its first two games, losing to Montreal and Buffalo. Thornton behind the net. One of the real strong centers in front to Samsonov, and he can't get it by Caron. I'm not sure if Caron got a piece of that or not. I
think he might have got the right toe on him.
Man, the last second, a very good scoring chance. And from behind the net, there probably is not a better center in the league right now than Joe Thornton in moving the puck or dishing, distributing from anywhere around that net area from behind. And he set up Samsonov beautifully. Koltsov around that far side, and the Penguins finally will get the puck out of danger.
It's time for a change, Mike. A lot of times we have celebration ceremonies here to start a hockey game. You want to get a short shift in there and get everybody on the bench into the action.
Bergeron against Crosby, and the Bruins come away with the puck. Bergeron, one of the real bright young stars in the National Hockey League. Very talented. Crosby along the far boards has scored in his first two games of the National Hockey League. And a whistle and a holding call here in the Boston Bruins. Maybe guilty of the first penalty here. A minute 24 in. Milan Jersina picks up the minor penalty. And so the Penguins begin on the power play. Both their goals scored last night were on the power play. Pouncey with a right-wing shot. And Torbjörn makes the first save of the night for the Boston Bruins. Holding the stick to call. The Penguins set up the power play. This is Gonchar to Sidney Crosby. Down deep to Palfy. Ziggy Palfy tried to float it around, and it deflected up and caught the net behind Toivonen, so they'll stop the play, and it was off of Bruin. There'll be a face-off to the left of the Boston goal. And this is our Geico quote of the day. The chances are there, so it's going to come. But the power play has to be much better. It's just been terrible. Well, the Pens' power play overall, 3 goals on the year, 16.7%. Looking for a little better number than that to produce.
I think he's referring to the 5-on-3s numbers especially, Mike. 5-on-3, they've had 5 opportunities, have yet to connect.
Boston has struggled a bit in the early going. They've given up 3 power play goals, 75% on the penalty kill. That Gonchar really came to life last night in the third period, and he may end up being the quarterback. But Claire kind of scooped it to the goal, and he can't get it on the net. And the Bruins clear.
I think that's one thing they're trying to figure out right now. Who is the quarterback? It's always been Mario, but Gonchar, over the years, the numbers he's put up on the power play, he wants a biscuit as well.
I really think at the moment he's kind of deferring to Mario, as a lot of players do, and Mario with the puck. You just kind of harken back to the days of Sergei Zubov when Mario played with him, and Zubov wouldn't shoot the puck. And Gonchar is such a great goal scorer. And he really never got over it and ended up really being dealt to the Dallas Stars. And one of the trades that Craig Patrick says is one of the deals that he wished he could get back, but it never happened. And it's just one of those things with Mario playing. But I think it'll change here, particularly at this point of Mario's career, and Gonchar when this new personnel get more comfortable.
Well, any good penalty killer, what's he going to do, Mike? He's just going to shade towards Mario, so the other people are going to have to start shooting the biscuit.
Oh, Bergeron with a good wrister around the boards to get the puck out of the zone. That shows strength there. That is not an easy play, boy, and he did it just with nonchalant movement. Really unbelievable by just Bergeron. A lead pass, Palfy behind the defense. He's good! Jump out to a 1-0 lead and a power play goal by Ziggy Palfy.
Is that Brooks Orpik that fed the puck up and he's standing over by the bench right now? Ziggy Palfy, remember, no two-line pass anymore. And he split the D way up at the far blue line. Let's watch the Penguins snap it up, blue line to blue line. Palfy just gets through the defense. The puck trickles through the five-hole of Toivonen, and the Penguins get the first goal of the game. Look at this look from behind. Oh.
Power play chance for the Bruins. They've gone it here. And they begin play here with a man advantage. No power play goals and 10 chances for the Bruins on the year. Matt Murley off to Melikar, and he does a good job of clearing the zone.
Well, you got to know Jamnoff is going to be the leader on that power play when he gets back and healthy, so they're certainly missing him.
Melikar retreating, going to Sergei Gonchar. Penn's lead, 1-0, to be joined us late. A power play goal by Ziggy Palfy. His second of the year.
Look at this. The Bruins have this young kid, Bergeron, playing the point, Mike, on the power play.
He does everything for them right now. Samsonov with the puck. Look out. He shoots it, and that's behind the net. Samsonov and Thornton were both drafted in the same year, 97, both first-round picks. And the Bruins had two that season. Bergeron turns, protecting the puck. So smart for a young player. He has it, sets it up, skates over to the left wing board. This is Glenn Murray, the former Penguin. And he is a great natural goal scorer. Samsonov in front. He tried to sneak it by. Carano got a stick on it. Caron just seems to have matured, does he? Just get that feeling that he's reading the play much better. You need some experience in this league, boy, to be able to play, and he's doing a good job right now. Here's Murray shooting, save. Caron reaches, he went in. It got off of him, it went in the net, and the Bruins have tied the game at one. Oh, he had it once, twice, and somehow there's another goal scorer that finds a way to get the puck behind the net, Miner.
Well, the Penguins got beat out of the corner and going to the goal line. Joseph Melikar held the back post for fear of a backdoor play, and he let Caron square up on the shooter coming out of the corner. Let's take a look here. As Murray's going to get the puck, go across the crease. Melikar takes away the back door, and that puck is just pushed in. And they just jam that puck
somebody
underneath.
Somebody got a stick in there.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Watch the stick underneath the pads. Right there, 14, Samsonov is going to get credit for the goal. And it appeared that puck was frozen. Caron actually put it in himself after the shove by Samsonov.
So that will tie the game. It will be a power play goal for the Boston Bruins, I believe. And they have made it 1-1. Another penalty coming up against Boston.
Well, in the frenzy here, Caron, in a panic to freeze this puck, absolutely kind of perpetuates the motion. The puck was actually still underneath him, Mike, and kind of in a frenzy, not realizing whose stick was coming in by his glove. It was defenseman stick Gonchar. He panicked to freeze that biscuit, put it in the net himself.
Samsonov did get a stick on it, and he will get credit for the goal. Murray and Thornton on the assist. So the Bruins have notched the tying goal here. Penguins back in a power play and a penalty to Travis Green right in front of the Boston net. Penguins trying to jam it in. They can't do it. Lemieux skates it up the left wing side to the right wing boards to Jackman. Rick Jackman to Dick Tarstam to Lemieux. Back to Tarstam. He's open. Passing with Jackman to Tarstam. Shot blocked by P.J. Axelson. Behind the Bruins net, big Hal Gill at 6'7", takes the puck. Great play by Tarstam to keep it in. And LeClaire wheels and deals, going to Ryan Malone. Around to Lemieux. Sets it up for Tarstam to Lemieux in a 1-1 tie. Mario wheels and deals to Tarstam. Booming shot off the board. Right around the net. Trying to jam it in is Malone. Poivonen right there. Can he get it? Nobody can. Lemieux's got the puck finally. Mario in front. He tried to direct it off a stick and Kierman in behind the net. Finally. Jackman's blast. Save it. Rebound Lemieux. Hey! Johnson scores. Mario Lemieux. And the Penguins regain the lead 2-1. Oh, scratch my back with a hacksaw.
And the one thing I noticed different in the Penguins' power play as opposed to the first two nights is they started shooting the puck. Simply started shooting the puck. A couple went wide. Malone, a great effort to get the puck. Jackman on the net and the rebound to Lemieux. How many times have you seen it, folks? Lemieux coming off that off-wing boards, coming to the cage, picking up a rebound and banging it in the cage.
Thornton winning the draw. Back to the left point. Leach. Onto the goal where it hit the glove of Caron. Alfie just turns it down the board. Boy, you're seeing those longer passes without hesitation now. We saw in training camp, Bobby, in exhibition games, players were really not used to being able to pass across two lines. They're still so embedded in their brain that you can't make that play, but they weren't doing it for the longest time. But now it opens up, and you can see them making the long pass. Another penalty coming up against the Penguins this time.
Yeah, you saw, I believe it was the stick of LeClaire reach out.
Delayed penalty call. Penguins must gain possession. They have to touch the puck and control it to get the whistle here. The Bruins have pulled their goaltender, but they will now as Caron touches up. And yet another penalty, this one at 13:36. will give the Boston Bruins a man advantage.
Well, Johnny LeClaire right at the Penguins' blue line. Just tugged at one of the Bruins' defensemen entering the zone. And that's all it was, Mike. That's all it was.
Quite frankly, LeClaire is going to be one of the players, too, that is so used to playing the other way in the game, it's going to take him a while to get really used to it.
And that was it.
You see a lot of players, they react after they make the play or hook or a hold. And when they're there and they go, they know it. They know they've made a mistake, but just by habit, they can't stop themselves. And it's going to take some time. Anu Toivonen. NHL debut and goal for the Boston Bruins. In the last 2 years with the Providence team in the American Hockey League. Slager tried to hold it, couldn't. Penguins after the puck. Bergeron covering after playing the point. Plays it up the boards quickly. The Bruins right back on the counter. Boys will settle up on the near side now. He gives the puck behind the net. McKechnie. Challenged by Joe Menikoff from behind the goal. Boys held. There'll be a penalty against the Penguins again. And Gonchar is going to be the guilty party. Bruins have a two-man advantage. They pulled the goaltender. Penguins need to get a whistle here. The Bruins shoot the puck, and that misses. And let's get it out of the zone. That'll kill some time. That, frankly, will help the Penguins, I think.
Bergeron's just going to put it in there so they get the face off.
Absolutely.
And Caron, you see Caron didn't want to touch the puck.
Yeah.
Caron let the puck go there. That was a smart move. He didn't want to stop the clock right away. Melikar played the puck.
But Bergeron, a young guy like that, knowing he knows, he just dumped it in.
What a great play. That's all it takes right now, folks. You cannot put your stick, other than on the stick of another player, you cannot put it on the body, the arms, the hip. Gonchar did. The Penguins will lose him. It's a 5-on-3 opportunity for the Bruins.
Boy, they don't waste much time. You don't even have time to write them down. So hang in there. Here we go. 5-on-3 for the Bruins. Just over a half a minute. Two-man advantage time. They're trying to tie the hockey game. Bergeron staying at that left point. Top of the circle. Passes down. Gets it back. Bergeron once again down low to Samson. Off to Bergeron. Brister. Partially blocked, I think, by Orpik. And it jumped over the top of the net. Here's a good play by Talbot to get the loose puck. Short-handed by two men, and he throws it up ice.
Some great work by the Penguins defenseman. It's so hard. You have 3 against 5. You want to take away the backdoor play, and that's what Pops did just beautifully.
Will Thort rolls it around the board. Glenn Murray on the near side. First penalty's over to LeClaire. Here's Bergeron shooting and scoring. He does it all. He ties the game as Bergeron just picks the corner he wants. Gets it by Caron. We're tied again. It's a power play goal, and that'll even things up because we were into the second penalty on Gonchar.
Now, Pops is going to break his stick on the play. Right in the corner, he gets slashed right there. So he's going to drop the twig. He's got nothing to play with. They go to Bergeron, and Pops has got nothing to stop the puck, if he could, on the way to the cage. One thing he couldn't do is take a stick in front of the net. Now, could he stop the Bergeron shot? No. It certainly doesn't help when you lose your stick in the corner. And just a beautifully placed shot by Bergeron. I wouldn't call that an overpowering shot, Mike. Just perfectly positioned with a little bit of a screen by Samsonov in front of the cage.
You know what that shot was? Brain shot.
The old brain shot.
That was a brain shot.
That's a new one, Mike. I'll go with it.
Mark Recchi leaves it for Crosby. Man open. A shot goes off to Ivan, and the Penguins score again. Rick Jackman. And it's 3-2 Pittsburgh. Wow. Boy, he's sitting on a bald man's hat. It's Rick Jackman scoring.
Well, Rick Jackman, the recipient of one of the finest passes. You know, we saw a good one last night. This one was equally as impressive by the kid, number 87, Sidney Crosby. Boy, can he set the table. He's got all the cutlery for this one, Mike. He puts it right on Jackman's tape. And Jackman, all you got to do is get it by the young goaltender.
Crosby's going to take center ice here. The Penguins will have a man advantage. Outshot by the Bruins, 14-10 in the opening period. It'll be a 5-on-4 here with Crosby, Recchi, and Palfy, the front line for Coach Eddie Olczyk.
We just got an update on Jocelyn Thibault. Just got that over our shoulder now. No broken bone. He will get an update, a reevaluation tomorrow, Mike. So they're going to look at him again tomorrow when the swelling hopefully goes down another MRI.
Remind the fans what happened today, Bobby, just those that may have joined us late.
Tuning in, Tebow got hit by Rico Fattis shot in the morning skate on the left knee and had to be escorted off the ice.
Leahy comes in with a shorthanded chance and Caron to his knees to make the save and then juggles the puck. A whistle did not sound. He looks around at the referee as if to say, well, where was the whistle? They finally get it and he has possession of it.
Got to be ready with a drop of the puck. The Penguins didn't appear ready, and the Bruins just jumped all over that. Almost tied this up in the early seconds of the second period.
And that would have been a shorthanded goal had he been able to do it. Well, he out of Boston, went to Miami University, another free agent college player the Bruins have signed, and they seem to find them all over the place. Here's Crosby going to work to that center. Hey! Sidney Crosby and the Pittsburgh Penguins have a 4-2 lead. Oh, hallelujah, Hollywood.
Well, Hal Gill is the biggest, longest reach in the National Hockey League, maybe. And Hal Gill got undressed by Sidney Crosby, who carried great speed through the neutral zone, put it between the stick and the body of Hal Gill, and boy, did he see Orpik moving up from his blue line position. Brooks Orpik, with a lot of folks looking back in Boston, is able to finish off a super feed. And look at Sidney Crosby here, folks. Look what he's seeing. How did he see him?
Well, right now, the Penguins with a two-goal lead with 12:28 left here in period number two. Al Gill. He had puck for P.J. Axelson. Down the ice he goes to the right of Caron. Sebastian Caron using the backhand and going to stop in play. Pat Parris is down below. Pat?
Well, Mike, a lot of ex-Penguin greats in attendance tonight. One of the greatest, Larry Murphy, the Hall of Famer, a great defenseman, number 55, of course, for the Pens. He's in the building because he's doing another HD broadcast. HD Net, the organization owned by Mark Cuban, the former Pittsburgher. Well, Larry Murphy is enjoying 30 games doing color commentary this year, and he tells me it's a way for him to keep in the game. He really loves doing it, and he kind of stumbled upon it doing FSN Detroit games 2 years ago, and now he's enjoying it for HDNet.
Well, Murphy still holds the record for most points by a defenseman, doesn't he? A rookie defenseman in the National Hockey League.
Now a member of
LA Kings.
Los Angeles Kings, the team he was drafted by. Axelson on to center now to Tommy Fitzgerald, and Fitzgerald connects on the right wing to Ian Moran.
Oh, Jesus, the collision there.
Melikar fell into Green, and Green's a little slow in coming to the bench.
You're both a little hurt. That was kind of like a car wreck there. Nobody could see it coming. Neither of them saw it coming, I don't think.
Axelson can't get into the Penguins' end. Backpedaling to be Yuri Slager.
A little more hitting in this hockey game than we've seen in the first game, right?
Colton Orr down the right wing. Heads back to the Penguins' zone. Wrister to the net. Stopped by Caron. He on the left side. He steps in. Nice play and he scores. What a move there. Patrick Leahy made a beautiful move to stuff it by Caron. And now the Bruins pull within one.
Oh, that really was a great move. Leahy's got a long reach and he got that reach, used it to get around the stick of Caron. The pads were open of Caron. I believe that's exactly where the puck went. Now let's take the reach. Around the stick, through the legs, and just inside that post. I mean, he's got such a long reach. Steals the puck on a little bit of a forecheck, and look at the stick handling ability for this long, lanky player, number 83. Wow, Mike. Boston
goal. Bob Errey, Mike Lang here at the Mellon Arena. Home opener for the Penguins here in period number two in a 4-3 game. Penguins jumped out to a 1-0 lead early in the contest on a Zeggy Palfy goal.
Well, look at that guy right there, distinguished gentleman, Randy Hillier. 1980 draft pick. Played with the Bruins from 81 to 84, as did his the other assistant coach, Joey Mullen, had a coffee break in Boston as well. He's upstairs on the headphones tonight, relaying down some tactics for these guys.
Bruins try the long lead pass. They rule no icing on the play. Fitzgerald back in front. Here's a shot to tie the game. Travis Green makes it 4-4. Well, there was a case there. where the linesman decided that it was a pass that might have been receivable. Did not call an icing call. The Bruins took advantage of it. Went down, set it up. Green scores. We're tied.
Well, goaltender Cron did play the puck. He didn't go around the wall. Instead, he gives the puck away, and he's not set for this shot by Travis Green. He is just not set for that shot as he scrambles back to get in position in front of the cage. He loses his footing, just gets to his knees as Travis Green deposits the puck short side, and he's got a, only one person to blame for that one, Mike.
Time of the goal, 10:30. Green is first.
Bruins take advantage.
At 10:30.
Oh, they've scored a couple of goals here in just over a minute and a half to tie the game at four.
You would like to go around the wall with this and not go, you know, see, he doesn't go around the wood with it. Goes right to the Bruin player. The pass doesn't connect. And boy, you can see the disgust right there as he looks down.
This faceoff will be to the right of Caron. Sergei Samsonov. Glenn Murray is there. Bruins starting to feel like they can score here now, and that's not a good sign for the Pens. They've got to try and answer.
Well, that's why they call the timeout. Edzo trying to turn the tide, Mike. He realizes that Boston has turned it. And boy, we got a lot of time in this hockey game. Eight goals already.
And the Bruins already with 27 shots. Keep that pace up, they will score more goals.
The Penguins have given up 37 and 30 respectively the first two games.
Mario Lemieux trying to stop it, and he does! He gets the Penguins the lead right back! Lemieux with his second, and the Penguins have the lead 5-4. How much fried chicken can you eat?
Well, give Eddie Olczyk some credit for calling the timeout, coming back with the lineup, the unit he wanted. And Lemieux with that long reach, Toivonen lost his post. The goaltender, Andrew Toivonen, lost his post there. You got to get your skate jammed against it. He lost his post, lost his balance. And from behind the cage, you see the puck sitting there. A second crack for Lemieux. And that was an easy one for the goaltender, Toivonen. Mike, he lost his balance, lost his post with that right skate.
Where's Joe Thornton been tonight?
Maybe the paycheck bounced.
No, I don't know. We've seen Joe Thornton dominate games against the Penguins tonight. At least at this point, it hasn't happened. Bergeron certainly has picked up any slack there.
And there's going to be a penalty here to Hal Gill on Mark Recchi. Mark Recchi, the wrecking ball.
He got in front of Hal Gill.
Oh, yeah, he got in a wreck. He's going to win this one. You see, if the players are equal, then they're both entitled to the puck. But if one guy's got a head up on the other one, like Mark Recchi did to Hal Gill, he's got an advantage. Just right there, he's got the advantage, and he cuts in on Hal Gill and draws a penalty. Hal Gill wasn't too happy with the call, but that's what happens with the wrecking ball, keeping his feet moving.
Well, we saw it last night with Gonchar, and help me with the Hurricanes winger.
Oh, Hedekin. Like, Brett Hedekin moving his feet coming out of the zone for the Kings.
Time of the penalty, 17:48.
Yeah, Turkey is on the table once again for the Penguins. See if they can convert. Ziggy Palfy on the right wing side. Crosby across to Gonchar. Shot, save made. It comes off now, and the rebound attempt by Recchi comes right back towards Hannu Toivonen.
Well, how about that pass? Toivonen getting a look at this Penguin power play from a lot of different angles. And right there, he was fortunate. After that rebound came out to the stick of Mark Recchi, that it didn't go behind him.
Interference, the call against Gill. Into the corner goes Crosby. Dish it off here to Recchi to the left point. Jackman flags it down with a glove. Uses the stick to move it over to the right side to Gonchar. Back to Jackman. His shot blocked by Travis Green. 5-4 Pittsburgh late in the second period.
Leach out to the point to force the play. Did you see Brian Leach out to the Penguins' point?
Crosby looking. Loose in front. Still a loose puck picked up by Recchi. Johnson scores. I think it was Crosby. Crosby does get the goal. And Sidney Crosby has scored his first goal ever in a Pittsburgh Penguins uniform. Oh, slap me silly, Sidney.
The let's take a look at the first career goal in the National Hockey League by Sidney Crosby. The Penguins on the power play. Crosby on the doorstep right there. Watch Lemieux. Oh, he's the happiest man in the building right now. Why not? And it's a three-point night for Crosby.
The Penguins convert again and lead 6-4 over the Bruins here late in period number two. And back to play the puck will be Brooks Orpik. Penguin defenseman to touch and we have an icing call.
Well, for Sidney Crosby, he's been the best Penguin on the ice tonight. A three-point night, he's plus three. Just standing on the doorstep, picking up a little bit of garbage. That's some great garbage.
Anu Toivonen will be the first goaltender to feel the history of Sidney Crosby in a Penguin uniform. And a high stick. Another penalty coming up here. Caron had started off. Are the Bruins going to get another call? It looks as though they will with 49.8 seconds left.
Now we have 17,000 plus in unison saying Crosby, Crosby. He's falling in love with this kid every time he touches the puck. And his youthfulness is really contagious through this Penguins lineup. It's a treat to talk with this kid. Passionate about the hockey game, talks, loves to talk hockey. And he's put in the time.
And it's grabbed by Hal Gill trying to clear. The Penguins back in the power play. Glenn Murray, a high-sticking call. The Bruins winger. And Mario Lemieux of the Penguins starts his rush back into the Bruins zone. It's Gonchar to the left point. Gonchar plays it right down the boards into the near corner for John LeClair. Time ticking down here. Tail end of period number two. Gill. After the Bruins are tied it. The Penguins called a timeout. They've come back and scored twice. Gonchar with a great chance. Onto the net. And Toivonen makes the save and the puck is cleared. And
Toivonen cleared his own rebound there with Malone on the doorstep ready to pounce on it.
Rick Jackman trying to get in. His slipper. His time ticks down and Toivonen has it. Still time for one quick faceoff.
One quick faceoff and this crowd on their feet. Just let the second tick off, Mike.
Well, do not be surprised if Lemieux gets this puck on the net. And Caron's going to come off. The Penguins have put an extra attacker on. And Mario has been able to do this. Thornton's his opponent, and he got it towards the net. Time's going to tick down, and that's the end of the period. At the end of two periods here in Pittsburgh, the Pittsburgh Penguins looking for their first win of the year. Have a 6-4 lead over the Boston Bruins. Sidney Crosby with his first NHL goal ever.
Welcome back to Mellon Arena. Penguins lead 6-4, and they lead 6-4 because of this puck right here. It's Sidney Crosby's first NHL goal. And as you see by the replay, the goal, the puck was actually thrown to center ice. The Penguins picked it up. Steve Latten, the equipment guy, got it, and they've already marked it. It says first NHL goal, 10-8-05 versus Boston. And you know Sidney will be holding on to this for a long, long time, guys.
In a lifetime. Thanks, Pat. And here's a shot by McEachran to the net. McEachran right around the goal, and he's stopped by Caron. I talked to Sean briefly before the game tonight. He was doing an interview, and he pulled me aside, and he said, Bobby, he said, I just want to tell you something, Mikey. He said, I bought a new boat this summer.
Did he?
Yeah. I said, well, that's fantastic. And he said, you know, I named it. I said, well, what'd you name it? He said, I named it the Butcher's Dog.
Did he really?
Yeah. Because I used
you.
The first time I used that, smiling like a butcher's dog when he came up.
Oh, yeah?
And scored his first
so
goal.
So Sidney's yacht's going to be Slap Me Silly.
Could be.
Yeah.
I just want to ride on both of them.
McEachran's got the 20-foot bow rider. This one here is going to be a little bigger.
Big chuckle on his face.
Oh, man.
Here's Gonchar with a biscuit. This should be icy. You have to wait now.
You saw it coming behind just to check.
Well, here's a look at our Subway sandwich of the game. Oh, looks orphic. I can hear that and feel that from here.
Oh, that's going to hurt in the morning.
Brooks Orpik's been laying the body on the ice as well as delivering his first goal of the season, second of his career.
Bruins still not out of this, trust me, the way the game is played right now. And we have still have a lot of time left to go. They've got an opportunity and they score right there, and it's 6-5. Glenn Murray. Oh, can he shoot the puck?
Premonition, right, Mike?
You know it, and I know it. Right now. This game is not finished.
Well, Glenn Murray's had some opportunities today. They haven't bounced his way. This puck, and it was a bouncing puck. Watch it. Bouncing over a couple of sticks by Malakars onto the tape of Glenn Murray, the ex-Penguin, and he wasted no time delivering that puck high over the blocker. And did you see that water bottle pop up?
Well, let's just say that that's probably turnaround is fair play, because he had to pass from Slager going down the slot that he couldn't get the wood to, that he could easily, in most cases, put in. That one comes back. It's a bouncing puck, and he snaps it right by Caron.
Never seems to make mistakes, scored the exact same way last night in Buffalo.
And frankly, be honest about it, when Glenn Murray played here and prior to coming to Pittsburgh, the first trip around with the Bruins, those kind of plays he didn't make. But he really refined his game. Here comes Lemieux back in a two-on-one with Koltoff. Lemieux's going to shoot it, and Toivonen just cradles it again right into that big Bruins B in the middle of the chest.
Dahlman took away that pass. I believe it was Dahlman on the two-on-one. Yes, it was. Took away the pass. That's how they teach it. Don't let Mario pass it over for the easy one-timer, the backside goal that we've seen so much here tonight. Let Lemieux square up with the goaltender. And that's a tough battle, but the goaltender won it on that occasion. Nice play by Dahlman.
So at the moment, Sidney Crosby's goal, if the Penguins were to win this hockey game, would be the game win. But here come the Bruins, and they're not done yet. Crosby stretching out, trying to beat three of the white-shirted Bruins. Penguins can't get in. They'll try again. Mark Recchi with that running style of skating. Kicks into the Bruins in. Bergeron plays the puck quickly. Back come the Bruins. McKechnie. Started his career with the Pittsburgh Penguins. He won a Stanley Cup with the Pens.
It's a tough start, isn't it?
Yeah. He'll never have the career Ken Morrow. The Islanders.
Olympics and a bunch of cups in a row.
Yeah. Right back in front. There's the Bruins score by Boys, and it's 6-6. Brad Boys ties this hockey game. And just like the Bruins did earlier in this contest, they score two goals very quickly.
Well, McKechnie entered the zone, won a battle, got the puck down low. And Boys are the recipient of a Leahy pass. Another great play by Leahy on the goal line again.
He's
set up.
Impressive. Oh.
And how about this puck? This puck goes up in the water ball as well.
Vocal guy, Ryan
he is
Malone.
Vocal there. He was a lot of that talking when the score was 4-4. And Ace is talking to Mario. That's his nickname amongst the guys. And
from Samsonov. And it is Caron poking the puck wide of the net, but Thornton behind the goal.
Bad pass it.
In front of Samsonov. Oh, he just missed, giving the Bruins a lead. Good stop there by Caron. Back of the Penguins. Rico Fatta. Arrieta cuts inside. Forgot one thing, the puck. The Bruins scoop it up again. Thornton, beautiful little soft pass to Leach. Here he comes into the Penguins, and he shoots it. Save made. Rebound. Is Mister trying to get it in? Leach, too. They cannot do it against Caron. Ooh, a long time before a whistle sounded, apparently, because they were chopping lumber there. Lumberjack style.
Oh, what a rush by Brian Leach. Mentioned all his accolades, but here at the end of a hockey game, as strong as ever, one of the strongest skaters that I've had the pleasure of playing with in New York. War number 2 in New York, number 22 here.
Well, he's nasty. I mean, there's no other way to describe him the way he skates.
Well, as a defenseman there, Mike, you want to turn him to his backhand there. He was allowed to turn back to his forehand in the middle of the ice, and that was dangerous.
Al Gill with a back pedal. And his attempted pass Hit one of the Bruins and jumps into the Penguins' end. It's a live puck. No two-line passes anymore. That red line has been eliminated. It's on the ice, and the reason it's on there is for icing. When you come to the game, just imagine that it's not there. I say we change the color of the line. We're going to make it a little less noticeable than what it is. Maybe that'll come on the next step. Changes. Recchi with the puck. Cross rink. Man there. Gonchar came late. Gonchar behind the net. This is almost like a four-on-four right now, the way these defensemen are all coming into the play.
They be careful.
Both ends, I know.
Your defenseman down there, down low at the end of a hockey game. And here's Ryan Malone covering up for him. Forward job to cover up for that defenseman down low.
Let's look at the realistic part of it here because, I mean, both teams at this point have a point in the game. Now you get into overtime, it's a little different, you know, ball game. If you lose here, Lemieux finally out the puck, and he's trying to finish. Just dropped him there. Lemieux behind the net, turns, looking. Got a man open, Gonchar lost it. And here come the Bruins. This is what I'm talking about. Going down is Murray, and it's taken away by goaltender Caron. And it's the Penguins' turn. Nobody's holding back. Both in. Lemieux comes one on two. Picked up by Orpik. He might have an opportunity. Goes to Lemieux with a good pass. Lemieux around. Tried to center it for Koltsov. But Samsonov read the play on defense. A minute 15. This is like an overtime. They're going
They're
for
not
it.
Worried about that.
No,
that
not at all.
They have in the back pocket. Not at all.
Crosby up the boards. Picked up by Bergeron. It took a weird bounce and a break for the Pens because the Bruins were in a line change.
Oh, 1 minute goodness. Remaining in the period.
You could just see
One
somebody
minute.
Coming on, throw it into an open net there. Recchi along the left wing side. Grab by the Bruins. They've got three Penguins back. But the Bruins have a couple players to beat still. Is Fisker shuffling to the net. That miss picked up right in front of turnaround shot by Bergeron. Stopped by Caron. Penalty coming up. Penguins will go to the box. It'll be Dick Tarnstrom. 41 seconds left.
Oh, Hartsom can't believe it. Out in front of the cage there. No, I mean, he tripped over Crosby. It was a tough call there on Tarnstrom. Just before that, Lemieux taking a great feed by Ryan Malone. Was denied possibly the game winner, but Tarnstrom just in the wrong position at the wrong time there. It appeared to me that Isbister just went down. He looked like he bumped into Crosby, Mike. That's what it looked like to me, but nonetheless.
Yeah, well, the Bruins have elected to take their timeout right now. And remember, if they do not score here in the next 41 seconds, this penalty will carry over into the overtime period. Very similar situation we had last night in Carolina.
Very same, yeah. Go to a 4-on-3, is that what you said, Mike?
Yes.
Sort of the 4-on-3 situation, but right now they're looking to win it in regulation. Second night in a row for the Penguins. 3 and 4 nights, maybe a little bit of fatigue, Mike. It's the third game in 4 nights.
For both teams.
Yeah.
For both teams. Yeah. I'm surprised they've played as strong as they have in the third here, really. They've gone end to end. They've played hard.
Oh, right they to have. The final buzzer here. And this is incredible. The Bruins with 40 shots on the board right now. The Penguins with 29.
All right, faceoff very important here. If you can win it, you're going to try against Big Joe Thornton. Talbot will try and do it shorthanded. And he does. Beautiful play by Talbot, and the Penguins take it. Can they clear? They can. Leach had it, but it's played off the boards and back to center. Who did that work? Again, Talbot. Two strong plays by the rookie. Well, those are little things again. We talked about Bergeron and all the things the Bruins did, you know, little things. Talbot just made two key plays for the Penguins to keep the Bruins out of the Pittsburgh zone.
Yeah, you're exactly right, Mike.
Burley.
You can't put a price tag
you
on
cannot.
Those things.
You can't. They didn't get a shot. 10 seconds to go on the power play, which if they win it here, if they get a goal, they win the hockey game. Bergeron, you get no points out of it. Leafs, they still have a chance. 1 second to go. Thornton to Bergeron. His shot sails over the crossbar as time runs out. And we are going to go to overtime. Here we go, 4-on-3. Thornton, let's see, the four is going to be Bergeron with him. Interesting how Sullivan changes up and uses Bergeron to work on the power play with him, although he's got Murray out with Thornton. Bergeron's going to play the point. This is pretty awesome foursome here they have. Right side, Thornton with a puck. threw it left side to Leach, and it went beyond his reach. A minute to go in the power play. Bergeron behind the net. Talbot out here, the lone forward. Orpik and pops back. Bruins have it. Thornton in front, and Leach just missed, giving the Bruins a game-winning goal.
It's one pass you can't give them, Mike. You know, you cannot give them that pass. He just went right under his stick.
Leach again. Over to the near side to Glenn Murray. Right back to Leach. Drives the net, goes in behind the goal. Thornton around. The Penguins in a triangle. In front, they try and go to Leach again, and he couldn't get it on the net.
Well,
but he was there.
If that was Murray, it'd be in the cage. We'd be going home.
Murray is around the goal. They go to Bergeron. Slapper. He can't find the target. Penguins being pressured here. Thornton back. Gives the puck to Leach. Now back to Thornton. Leach way in deep. 4-on-3. In overtime. The puck played away from the net. The Penguins will get to it. Pops trying to clear. Can't do it. 5 seconds to go in the power play. From behind the net. Ready to come on as Tarnstrom. He'll have to get in the zone. McMurray. There it is. It's over. Glenn Murray finishes it. The Bruins win in overtime. Well, you picked that one.
Well,
right on the money.
I've seen him too much.
So have
you seen him play? You know that if he has got an opportunity to hit that empty cage, he's going to hit it with force. Great pass by Thornton.
Absolutely.
Right on the tape.
Yep. And the Penguins were just out of gas. They were down, and the Bruins kept going. And the line we talked about, Thornton picked it up in the third. He sets up the game-winning goal, and Glenn Murray notches his second, and it's the game winner.
Well, you said it, Mike. I mean, Pope's was on his backhand, and that was a long penalty kill. He couldn't clear the puck. It got to Thornton, and it was in the net. Bing, bang, bong, just like that. And this crowd, who was, I tell you, they were entertained tonight. Have to go home feeling like they're missing out on something.